Hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com. Welcome right into this Adobe Illustrator tutorial where we're going to cover five tips and tricks for the Pathfinder panel that you maybe have not known about before. The Pathfinder is such an incredibly useful tool when it comes to shape building in Adobe Illustrator, and the more you know about how to work with Pathfinder, the more you're not going to feel like you're running into a situation where you can't figure out how to make a shape in Illustrator. And making shapes is kind of the name of the game when you're working with most types of illustration. Maybe not all, but a lot of them. If you enjoy this tutorial, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to the YouTube channel so you never miss any video editing. Well, not video editing. Who cares about that? There are video editing tutorials over there, but graphic design related, Photoshop, Illustrator, you name it. Those kind of tutorials, they're all here on the channel. Subscribe so you never miss them. And let's jump into Adobe Illustrator right now and check this thing out. All right, here we are in Adobe Illustrator. I'm going to open up the Pathfinder panel because that's kind of what we're going to talk about here. You can find it under Window Pathfinder. If you've never used it before, well, stick around because you can do an awful lot with the Pathfinder. I've got some shapes here I've been messing around with and playing with. Actually, all this stuff over here I thought I was going to incorporate into the video, but it's not really. But I thought it looked kind of cool, so I'm just going to leave it there. Let's take a look at this little courthouse-looking shape first. I want to show you a couple things here with this with regard to the Pathfinder panel. So let's select this. And let's grab these three sort of rounded rectangle extended pill shapes, and I'm going to go object arrange. I'm going to bring these to the front so they're on top. We could do something like where we select all these shapes and we say, hey, look, a Pathfinder minus front. And what this is going to do is it's going to take those front shapes and it's going to just use them to punch a hole in the stuff behind it. Now you can see we only really got one object left and we're kind of stuck with that object. So it's a little messy. With something like this, you might be better off creating a compound shape. And you can do this by Alt or Option clicking on that shape mode. And you can see it looks different, but it doesn't look as different as we want because we still want the top of the courthouse to be there. Let's undo it one more time. And I'm going to select the top and bottom of the courthouse shapes, and I'm going to group them, object to group. And now I'm going to select everything, Alt or Option click on the shape modes. And there we go. Now we preserve the top and bottom of the courthouse, and we have the sort of cutouts that we want. But the cool thing about the compound shape is you can double click to get within it, and you can take the shapes that make up the compound shape and adjust them and push them around wherever you want them to go. So we could take the shape essentially that looks like that, and we could, you know, we could do this with it. I could push this down and it almost looks a little bit more like an airplane. Maybe I could take the bottom shape if I double click into here. I'm sorry, not double click into here. Use the direct selection arrow, select that. I could shift this up a little bit, maybe something like that. And we have more of, I don't know, some kind of bizarre looking airplane shape. The point is, when you're working in a compound shape like this, you preserve all of your shapes and you're able to go in and continue editing the sort of compound shape that you've created. If you decide you want to move these shapes around later, maybe the client says they want the pillars to be quite a bit narrower and closer together, something like that. You can easily come in and just shift them around like that, and that's all you have to do. You don't need to redraw the entire shape or go in and delete a bunch of anchor points and join a bunch of anchor points together and mess around with stuff like that. So there is some merit to Alt or Option clicking on some of these modes over here in Pathfinder and creating a compound shape instead of just willy-nilly going and punching holes and joining stuff together just like you normally would. So the next shape I want to talk about is this interesting looking shape here where I have a number of rounded rectangles that are overlaid over this sort of rectangle that I've cut all these shapes into. And I'm looking at this and I decide, you know what, I want all of these to be merged together. So I can select them all and I can use the merge function here in Pathfinder. And then I decide I'm looking at it and I want these shapes, I want to drag these straight down to like here. The problem is you can see I've got these like teal lines that are left behind, and they're left behind because there are anchor points that are left behind there. You can see all these anchor points along here that get left behind. Well, we can get rid of most, if not all, of these anchor points on kind of a regular basis. I'm going to undo this to get me back to just my normal shapes. There's an option here in the Pathfinder panel under Pathfinder options called Remove Redundant Points, Redundant Extra Unnecessary Points. So now I can select all of this stuff, I can choose merge, and you can see, sure enough, virtually all of those extra points are gone. There are a couple that are still there, and it's probably because the path is not 100% aligned and precise as it should be, and that's something that I would need to go in and fix. But everywhere where it's lined up perfectly, we don't have all that overabundance of extra anchor points, and at this point we could grab these rounded points, drag them all the way down, and we have no weird funky lines that are being left behind. All right, for the third shape and the third tip, I should say, I'm going to drag over these two ellipses here to select them. And what I'm going to do is come into my Pathfinder drop-down or flyout menu here and choose to make these two shapes a compound shape right off the bat. And you can see what I've got here now is this donut shape. And if I double click into my compound shape, because I just didn't use a shape and punch a hole randomly in the middle of it using minus front, I can still select this circle and adjust this and line it up exactly as I wish. So there's a lot that I can do here. Now, in this case, I probably just want to leave it in the center and keep my little donut shape and then hit the escape key to get out of isolation mode. And I have this nice donut shape. But again, very important to note, it is very editable. You can go in there, and here I'm just selecting it with my direct selection tool. You can go in there and move it around and change things up just as you wish, very, very easily. All right, let's move down over here. And the fourth thing I want to show you is if we take something like this, this shape, it's just essentially a tilted square, and it's going to be cutting a piece out of the front of this donut shape to make the letter C. But for whatever reason, I want to save some of the pieces of the shape, so instead of just going with like a minus front, I'm going to go with the divide function here. So I'm going to go divide, and this is going to put all the stuff, as you can see here in my layers panel, it's putting it all into this group. I can ungroup it, Command-Shift or Control-Shift-G, and I've got this shape here. I've got this shape on the ring. Whoop, I don't want to double click into it. I've got that shape of the ring. I got this little piece here, but I also have this just blank empty path that's unused in there. It's kind of annoying when you have this stuff, because if I were to select this and say, you know what, instead of this being the seafoam green, I actually want to move it to more of a light blue. Well, when I select everything, obviously this unfilled path gets selected and filled as well. So again, we have the option in Illustrator, in the Pathfinder panel, under Pathfinder Options, to divide an outline will remove unpainted artwork. So stuff that doesn't have a fill or stroke, get rid of that stuff. I'm going to say, yeah, go for it. Give it to me. So I'm going to take these. Now I'm going to divide, and I'm going to ungroup Command-Shift or Control-Shift-G, and I'm going to select the shapes one at a time. There's that shape. There's that shape. There's that shape, and there's nothing left in the center. All we have is our nice letter C, and if I select all this stuff, I can easily change the color, and nothing else is affected. So the last thing I want to show you, the fifth little tip and trick, the hidden tip and trick in Pathfinder, is the ability to quickly and easily repeat a Pathfinder operation with a hotkey. So this is really useful when you're working on very intricate illustrations and building very complex shapes. I find it particularly useful when I'm sort of outlining artwork and I just have a lot of pieces that are going and either need to be merged together or divided apart or whatever it may be. Being able to execute something that's going on over in the Pathfinder panel that you need to do a bunch of times in a row with a hotkey is nice, because instead of disengaging your mouse and moving from here all the way to wherever your Pathfinder is and then back, you can just bam, 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 use a hotkey. So what we can do is we could select two of these rings here, right? You see these rings? And maybe I just want to merge them together. So I'm going to choose the little merge option here, and now they're merged together. Now, I didn't realize at the time when I selected these that maybe I wanted to merge the next one. So what I can do is I can use the flyout menu, and there is the repeat merge option. And I don't know why it makes it even more difficult to go into a flyout menu to hit repeat merge. The only thing I can think is maybe they made it a menu option so a hotkey could be assigned to it. And that's what the hotkey I want to talk about. And it is Command or Control and the number 4. And then we can select by shift clicking the next ring, Command or Control 4. And then we see them. We're like, yeah, that's pretty cool. I actually want to move this up here, maybe kind of like this. Something like that. We're going to nudge this until it looks about like that. And then we'll select all these shapes and Command or Control 4. And we just go ahead and merge all these shapes together into this one very, very much more complex shape than what we had. And then if we look at our big rings and we say, you know what, we actually want all these merged together as well, Command or Control 4, boom. They're all merged together just like that. One giant shape that easily. A little Command or Control 4 to just repeat the previously used Pathfinder operation here in the panel. It actually is much more useful than it sounds at first glance, especially if you're working with complex shapes and complex illustrations where you just want to quickly be able to grab a couple shapes and boom, perform an action that you've been performing all day long. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is it for this one. If you enjoyed it, again, make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel so you never miss any Illustrator tutorials in the future. And you can give me a follow over there on Instagram if you do the Instagram thing. That'd be cool as well. But for now, for repeating a Pathfinder action, for removing redundant points, for deleting unfilled artwork, and all the other stuff about Pathfinder that we covered in this kind of casual jaunt through the Pathfinder panel in Adobe Illustrator, ladies and gentlemen, that is it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.